Hey, welcome back. Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond for our latest in AlphaGo versus the world. Michael, we have a new player today, don't we?
Yeah, King Junghyun, I think. He's a Korean player. And he became a one-dan professional in 2009. Mm-hmm. He was born in Korea in 1991. So let's see, that makes him, he's in his mid-20s.
Okay.
And, I think now he's a six-dan. He was a player who liked territory, so he liked to play 3-4 points. And with white, he played some star points too, so that was his style at the time.
So I think we've maybe had one Korean player. It's been pretty much all Chinese up until now, but I think we're sort of moving into a bunch of Korean players now, right?
Yeah, it looks like that. There's going to be a number of players who are from Korea. We're going to be playing in the next few games.
Yes. All righty. Things should get exciting. Can't wait. All right, let's take a look at the game.
Well, the big thing about this game, actually, is that we're going to see a direct 3-3 point.
Whoa!
So this is one of the three games in this series where we had something that we might call a direct 3-3 point. And I was really surprised to see it. But it was like something, I forget, was it the 19th move or something like that, which was the record in this series? Uh-huh. And of course, nowadays we see the 3-3 point in a position like this sometimes.
Right, sure, sure.
And so like it can be the fifth or the sixth move. At the time, having a 3-3 invasion in the first 30 moves was a big deal.
Sure.
Okay, so black is AlphaGo, and black plays the big shimari. And I see this pattern where black plays this big shimari when white has the two star points. And you might remember that it's playing the large knight's shimari when white has the 3-4 point there. So that's the way AlphaGo, it's just a pattern that AlphaGo had. White plays a kahari. And this is where modern computer programs will tell you to play the 3-3 point maybe. Uh-huh. Or otherwise, this is also a good point that we'll get a good score in general. But they don't play this kahari anymore. And black plays a pincer. Now, this is sort of interesting because I would have expected black to play here.
Right.
This actually is a very human-looking joseki that AlphaGo chooses to play. This is a joseki that was very, very popular at the time, where black would play this normal joseki. And if white jumps into the 3-3 point, black gets a big moyo here like this. This is a sequence that would be played a lot at the time, where black is going to build a moyo in the lower right part of the board. Maybe or maybe not, AlphaGo is going to do that. So white jumps out and slides. When white does this, it was also a very popular move for black to play this kick at this point to see how white responds. Because if white responds something like this, black gets a double hane here. Or actually, black can start with this move and then play the double hane. That works also. And black gets to close white in here. And when white extends here, this is the game move. Black now plays an extension on the side. And next, black is threatening to start a ko here, for instance, like this. And just because black has started with this exchange, the ko is a very strong threat that black has here. Black is setting up this ko with that marked exchange. So in this case, black could continue with something like this. And the ko in the upper right area is so important that white would be forced to add some stone here. For instance, maybe here, or maybe here would be a move that a human player would usually choose, but this would be a success for black in any case.
Wow.
So black is setting up this ko here. And white has to add a stone. And the fact that black has forced white to play one more move there and black gets an extra initiative, by human players also, this was considered to be okay for black. It was supposed to be good. And so AlphaGo is playing exactly the same variation that was very popular among human players. And at this point, the game is still pretty close to even. But what I was surprised at is that it looks like a human game. And with computer programs, quite often it doesn't. So white answers here. This is a point, again, where if only, you know, Kim had about 20 years to, or at least 10 years to see what computer programs are suggesting, he would know that white is supposed to play here and jump or something like that. And so this is what you would see nowadays, where white is just making it so more difficult for black to take the initiative, I suppose. And white is looking at this invasion here next. Nowadays, people think it's okay to kick, but this is perfectly normal for the time. And here we're going to get the direct 3-3 point. So this is move number 19.
Wow.
And, you know, I was shocked to see it at move 19. I think another game, maybe it was something like move 31. I was shocked every time. And nowadays, we're seeing the direct 3-3 point invasion in move number 5 or 6. So it just shows me how the game has changed so much. And this is a point where white plays this way, and white extends the old-fashioned joseki, which now just about everyone is saying is bad for white. It's just too slow. So what should white have done? It turns out, after all, white does play the double hane. And this is something I can suggest to just about anyone. If these direct 3-3 invasions annoy you and you don't know what to do with them, just play the double hane. It's a relatively simple joseki. And white gets the corner territory. Yeah. So it's a simple way to deal with that. And when black jumps into the 3-3 point, if black is a human player, that player probably has the idea that he's going to take away the territory and then attack your role on the outside. So this is a good way to change it around and take the corner territory. As a strategy, you might say, in a human game, it's probably a good idea also.
Yeah, I like that.
And just the simplicity of this is good. And it turns out this is what gives you a good score with computer programs too, in many cases.
It's simple and it gives you a good score. What more do you want?
The other alternative, of course, is to get into this joseki, which can work, but it works in different ways depending on the board position. So you have to know it fairly thoroughly. Right. Whereas the double hane that I was showing here, this is something you can just use relatively few variations. So white extends in the game. We still had the idea that this was supposed to be good for white. Another joseki in the upper left, that's nothing wrong with that. Black pushes. So far, we've had three josekis. Like this joseki in the upper right was a very popular joseki. The joseki in the lower left, at the time of this game, we thought that this was supposed to be good for white. The joseki in the upper left is popular, so it's supposed to be even. At this point, already Lilo Zero is giving AlphaGo something like 58% winning percentage. So that's about 2 points after Komi. So for AlphaGo, that's a pretty decisive difference already.
Game is over, right? I mean.
Well, yeah, but I'm going to show you a bit more actually in this case. The suggested move is for white just to leave the upper left corner, and this just taking the initiative on the lower side, trying to make something of the lower side using that wall, would have given white a chance. The problem with the game that made this worse for white was that white was too slow in implementing that. So in the game, white adds a stone to the upper side, admittedly a big move, but black gets to play this extension here. Actually, this move was mixed in, but black plays this extension on the left side. This extra stone on the left side is going to put more pressure on white's wall. And so we're going to see an example of how the direct 3-3 point combined with an attack on the wall outside is going to work very effectively. So this is white's next mistake, where white should have just played a more tight in extension and allowed black to play here. Something like this, it would still keep the game at about, it's still bad for white. Like black still has something close to 60% winning percentage, but this would have been better, in which white would not be getting attacked severely here in this area. In the game, white plays a wider extension. Usually with a wall, you want to play a wide extension. But in this case, with the black stones already sort of gathering together around that white wall, getting ready to attack, this was a bad idea because black just jumps in. And this is kind of the textbook example of AlphaGo attacking a wall. This is how you do it. This is the example that we used that made the, I think this game was the game that made the Directory 3-point invasion so popular.
Yeah.
Even among professionals. It's such an easy to understand example of how Black should set up an attack on the wall after taking away the 3-3 point.
It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. I mean, Black has taken territory on the left. It's got a nice flexible shape in the middle there.
Just having taken the corner territory and then having the opportunity to attack White on the outside like this, it's too good to be true almost, but it's working. And at this point, Black is something like 70%, close to 70, I think, yeah, about 70%. And that translates to something like 14, 15 points before coming. Right. So it really, even in looking at it myself, there's no question that I want to have the black stones in this
game. I'm going to say that even for an amateur such as myself, I look at those string of stones that has maybe one gote on the side, and you just feel so bad.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, man. Wow. Really beautiful game. I can't wait to see the more extensive analysis in the book. So something to look forward to, folks, as well as our next game. So thank you, Michael. Thank you all for watching. See you next time.